Hello friends, welcome to my channel Q12. Today we are going to solve few numericals related to the topic conservation of momentum. So first is the velocity of a body of mass. It's better if you solve the question along with me so that you know you can just match the solution whether you have done it correctly or not. So the velocity of a body of mass 10 kg increases from 4 meter per second to 8 meter per second when a force acts on it for 2 seconds. So there are three parts in this question. First one is, what is the momentum before and after the force acts? Second, what is the gain in momentum per second? Third, what is the value of the force? So let's solve it. First we'll write what all we have. So the mass is 10 kg. Increases from 4 meter per second to 8 meter per second. That means initial velocity is 4 meter per second. And final velocity is 8 meter per second. Time period that is given is 2 seconds. So first it is asking, what is the momentum before and after the force acts? So now the formula for momentum is momentum, that is P before and after. So I write before for B. So before is mass into velocity before. So that would mean initial velocity. So mass is 10. Times u is 4, so I will get 40, and the unit is kg meter per second. So this is my momentum before the collision. Now momentum after the collision, I represent A for after. So mass into after, that means final velocity, so it will be v. Now m is 10 times, what is the final velocity? 8. So I'll get it as 80 kg meter per second. So this was my A part of the question. Now the B part of the question says that, what is the gain in momentum per second? So gain in momentum, that means it is asking for, gain in momentum will be P final, that is P after the collision, minus momentum before the collision per second. So it means you need to put time as well. That I go as per the question. So what is my PA? That is 80 minus, what is my PP? That is 40. What is my t? That is 2. And the units will be, what is the unit for this one? It's kg meter per second, and for time also we have seconds, so it will be kg meter per second square. I hope this is clear to you. Let's go to the last part. So it says, what is the value of the force? Now force is the rate of the change of momentum, per unit time. Now above in B part of you will see, this is change in momentum divided by T, and this is also the unit of force. So my answer will be 20 Newton, or you can put in this units as well, if it will be perfectly fine. I hope this is clear to you. Let's move on to the second question. The second question says, a boy pushes a ball with a force of 20 Newton. What is the magnitude and direction of the force experienced by the body? So now the force applied is 20 Newton, and you need to tell the magnitude and the direction of the force experienced by the body. So equal and opposite according to the third law, so it will be minus 20 Newton. Next, a 20 gram bullet is shot from a 5 kg gun with a velocity of 500 meter per second. What is the speed of the recoil of the gun? Now you have to tell the final velocity. So a 20 gram bullet is shot from a 5 kg gun with a velocity of this. So now see, you can solve it using two methods. Force applied by the bullet is minus of force applied by gun. Or you can take anywhere, minus can go any side. So for the bullet, FB. Now we have what? We have the mass of the bullet, that is 20 gram. Mass of the gun, that is 5 kg. And is shot from with the velocity of this. Now velocity of the bullet is given to be 500 meter per second. Now when you have a look at the question, you will see that we need to find the velocity of the gun, right? MB, MG, VB, VG, I have these. So force will be, my initial velocity for all of this is, like for gun is equal to that of the bullet, is equal to 0 meter per second, right? So I'll take this relation, and then I will derive my velocity of the gun. So mb, that means mass of the bullet, vb minus ub divided by, either you can use a direct formula or you can derive this direct formula of conservation of momentum, or you can find like this, vg minus ug divided by time. Now the time taken is same in both the cases, so it will get cancelled out. Mass of the bullet is 20 grams. See, this is gram, this is kg. So to convert it into kg, I need to divide it by 1000. Yes? So I will have 20 divided by 1000. Now Vb is 500 minus 0 is equal to mg, that is 5. Vg, I need to find, minus ug, that's it. On solving, so this 500 minus 0 will be 500 only, Vg minus 0 will be Vg only. 500 divided by this to 10, yes? So, 10 equals 5 Vg. Hence, I will get the velocity of the gun as 2 meter per second. I hope the question is clear to you. The second method that I was speaking was that initial momentum equals final momentum. So since initial momentum here, obviously both are at rest, so it's 0. So it will be 0 equals final momentum. And if you would have done this, then you would have got it. 0 equals final is mass of the bullet into velocity of the bullet plus mass of the gun into velocity of the gun. Right? And from there you will arrive here directly, if you will see. I hope this is clear to you. Next, let's move on to the next one. The next question says, a 10 gram bullet is shot from a 5 kg gun with a velocity of 400 meters per second. What is the speed of the recoil of the gun? It is same as the previous one. Here, a 10 gram bullet is given. You will convert the 10 gram into kg and then you will do accordingly. Next, when two bodies A and B interact with each other, A exerts a force of 10 newton on B towards east. Now, so this is my A and it exerts a force on B. How much force is it applying? A force of 10 newton towards east. You need to tell what is the force exerted by B on A. So since it's equal and opposite, right? So that will be minus 10 newton. So you can say it will be, either you can say minus 10 newton or you can say 10 newton towards west. Okay? Let's move on to the next question now. Now the next question says, a man weighing 60 kg runs along the rails with a velocity of 18 km per hour and jumps into a car of mass 1 quintal standing on the rails. Calculate the velocity with which car will start travelling along the rails. So you're given the mass of the man, velocity, jumps into a mass of quintal standing on the rails. 1 quintal is equal to how many kgs? 1000 kgs. Calculate the velocity with which the car will start travelling along the rails. It is same as the previous one. You have both the masses. You have one velocity. You can find the next one. Initially, both were at rest. So, initial velocity will be 0. Next, a bullet of mass 10 kg is fired from a gun of mass 6 kg with a velocity of 300 meter per second. Calculate the recoil velocity. Same concept. Next, a gun of mass 3 kg fires a bullet of mass 30 grams. The bullet takes this much seconds, 0.003 seconds, to move through the barrel of the gun and acquire a velocity of 100 meter per second. Calculate the velocity with which the gun recoils, the force exerted on gunman due to recoil of the gun. Let's do this one. So the question says, a gun of mass of the gun is 3 kg, mass of the bullet is 30 grams. The bullet takes 0.003 seconds to move through the barrel of the gun and acquire a velocity. So velocity of the bullet, it will be 100 meter per second. And you need to calculate the velocity with which the gun recoils. So Vg we need to calculate. In second one, we need to calculate the force exerted on gunman due to the recoil of the gun. So force exerted by the gun. Yes, or force exerted by bullet, it will be same. Let's do this question. So now in this question we have been given all this. What will be the initial bullet velocity? 0. And initial gun velocity? 0. All these questions follow a simple basic formula, that is conservation. Whenever you see a question related to gun or you are walking in which you know equal and opposite force is being applied, simply use a conservation of momentum. Simple, simple technique. Now here I have been given everything. So let's move Now I know initial momentum equals final momentum, that is my equation. So initial momentum of, now it's gun and bullet. So mv ub plus mg ug, that is my initial, equals, take the final one, so it will be v, mv vb plus mg vg. Simple, bullet gun, bullet gun, final, initial, final. Now I'll start putting in the values. So see, ub is 0, v, ug is 0, so this whole thing will become 0. So I will have 0 equals, now mv is 30 gram. So convert this gram into kg, I will have 30 divided by 1000, right? So 0 equals 30 divided by 1000. I would suggest never solve anything here. If you have something multiplication division, let it be, because it will get cancelled out here. So it will, you know, it will save you some time in the process. Now VB, VB is how much? 100 meter per second. Plus, what is my MG? MG is 3 kg times VG I need to find, right? Next, 0 equals, these two zeros cancel out, this zero cancel out. So 3 plus 3 VG. So obviously 3 VG equals minus 3. So I will have the velocity of the gun as minus 1 meter per second. Why minus? Because it's a recoil one. So automatically the minus sign comes. So you can identify even that this is a recoil velocity that the person, that the gun is having. Next, I need to find the force that is being applied. Now the force that is being applied on the gun. So force on the gun is, it's very simple, mass into acceleration, right, of the gun. So Fg is equal to, I know the formula is Ma, so I'll write G here, since G is here. Now mass of the gun, now acceleration of the gun will be velocity of the gun minus initial velocity of the gun divided by time, right? Now you will say, I do not have the time for the gun, I have the time for the bullet. The force applied by the bullet or the gun are the same. So what we can do is, for Fg, I can say this is also equals to minus F of bullet, right? So let me find these things for the bullet. Understood why we didn't take this? Because in the question, it was mentioned for TB. Simple. So V, MB, VB, UB and T. Since I need to find Fg, I need to put minus Fb, so I'll put minus sign here. Correct? Next. Let's put the value. VMB is how much? Minus 30 divided by 1000. VB, what is my VB? VB is 100. 100 minus 0, what is TB? 0.003. Okay, let's bring it here now. So it's minus 30 divided by 1000 into 100 minus 0 is how much? 100, right? Divided by 3. And how many decimal places are there? 3. So I will multiply in the numerator 3 zeros. Fine. Now these three will get cancelled out. 3, I'll get 10. So minus sign. What most of the students, the mistake that you do is that you forget about this minus sign. Signs are very important, you cannot forget about them. So it will be minus 10. How many zeros are there? 1, 2, 3. So 1, 2, 3. We are talking about force or Newton. Minus sign represents that this is a recoil force. 1000 Newton is your answer. I hope this is clear to you. I'll be posting few questions in the link below, in the descriptive box below. You can try to attempt them and you can post your answer in the chat box. I will have a look at it. If it's fine, I'll give you a thumbs up. So till the time we meet again, stay safe, stay connected. Next we will be starting with the chapter gravitation. Bye.